We couldn't begin to think about doing a Mexican episode without visiting Little Village. And you also can't do Mexican food without the three T's. Tortas, tequila, and al pastor. Spelling was never my strong point, but eating was, which is handy.
And Atotonilco has been an anchor in Little Village ever since Scotty Munoz's parents purchased the Taqueria 37 years ago.
My father passed away, unfortunately, last year. He was definitely a pillar of the community. He was a Mexican charro, and he brought us into the rodeos. And we've opened the parade for 26th Street for 25 years.
So why are you Chicago's best?
Because we've never skimped on the quality. We noticed that our customers are willing to pay a little bit more, but to be consistent. All our vendors are the same for 25 years. We're known in the community for the al pastor, the marinated pork and beef, and having authentic Mexican food. We don't Tex-Mex it. And I think that that's part of the success.
Oh, and you can smell that success the moment you walk in the door. Stacked daily, they have a fresh batch of al pastor spinning on their spit.
This is the traditional way of doing el al pastor. It's cooked well done from one side, and on the other side, it's like a medium well. It's 80% pork, we put some beef, and then we put some onions. It's different layers, we cap it.
And you know what I'm gonna ask next, don't you? When can I have some?
Right now. So this is the original way that in Mexico it's done. In the States, a lot of people just do it on the grill, just to save time.
But it doesn't taste as good.
Oh no.
It's a slow cook, it's been put together by hand, and guess what? It's being eaten by me by hand. That's a tendon. Excuse me. Don't mind me, I'm just gonna slice some more off to put on my torta, so.
With time, you know, with practice, you get it a little bit quicker.
This is like meat pole dancing.
Ooh la la.
I would pay to come and sit in here and throw dollar bills at this. To just keep on turning, look juicy. But slightly different, you generally don't eat after someone's dancing around a pole. Well, in two of the places I've been to, they do, but that's a different story.
Moving on. We toast our torta buns and pair our pork with a heap of lettuce, tomatoes.
We get some aguacate.
I like that. A little floured out.
This is crema agria.
Okay, what's in that?
Sour cream. And that's your torta right here. I know you came for the tortas, but yeah. I wanted to get you a little bit of everything that we do in Atotonilco. We have our milkshake, tortas de al pastor, and I brought you some tacos we have.
Come for the tortas, stay for the tacos, the milkshake, and the company. Okay, I've got to get stuck in. I thought the meat on its own was good, but putting with everything else, the meat with all the vegetables, it's just perfect. Perfect combination. When do I get to come back and learn how to do some traditional Mexican rodeo? Because I want to be riding the parade in September as a rodeo rider.
We gotta start today. After here, after eating the good food, we go to the farm, horseback ride, and we'll get you ready for the parade.
Alma, on Facebook, I have to thank you because you said they have the best old-fashioned tortas. And my God, you were right. There are also a ton of you who also said this is the place to come, and I love you all individually,